two of the most important concepts to understand as a data engineer are data warehouse and data lake. And maybe more importantly, what's the difference between them? So in today's video, that's what we're going to talk about. We'll talk about the difference between a data warehouse and a data lake, when you're going to use the two, so that ultimately you can walk away with a better understanding of them and be able to engage in discussions around them. So before we dive into each of those individually, I think it's important to take a step back and actually put in perspective, what are we even doing here? What's the purpose of a data architecture to begin with? And to me, there are three big reasons that we even do this to begin with. And I'm sure there's more, but let's just stick with these three. First of all, a lot of companies, pretty much every company, is generating data from various different sources all over the place. You know, they have different applications, different third-party tools that they use, all sorts of stuff, and they need to understand it. So the first goal is to just consolidate all of that information. We have information all over the place, get it in one place. And second is trying to figure out what happened with that data. What are all the events that happened? You know, what can we analyze from that? And the third reason, which probably summarizes the whole thing, is to have all this data so that we can make better decisions. Our whole purpose here is to take all of this data that's generated so that ultimately the business can make better decisions. Otherwise, why are we doing any of this, right? So with that in mind, let's talk about, where does a data lake and where does a data warehouse fit into this, and why do we use them? While data warehouse is probably a more well-known term, I actually want to start first with data lake, because if we think about what the whole purpose is and how we're taking all of these source system information and moving it over to make decisions, a data lake is going to be where all of the source system data gets put. It's a central landing zone for all of your data. It's unstructured. It's just dumping data constantly into this place. It's not in a consistent structure. It's going to be data in all different formats. So JSON, video files, text files, CSV, it's everything just dumped into one location. And this could be maybe in an S3 Amazon bucket. It could be Azure storage. You could use modern cloud databases like Snowflake and just load it all into a database server. You can pick wherever you want to put this. And this has become more of a requirement in a modern data architecture, because we're constantly generating more and more data in a modern world, right? We don't want to wait an hour or a day like in a typical ETL fashion. The idea instead is to just constantly be loading into this data lake. And then from there, you know, maybe once an hour, you pull from that data lake and do some transformations or whatever you want to do. So now let's talk about the data warehouse. In my mind, a data warehouse comes after a data lake, if you want to think about it linearly. The data is being loaded in its raw form into a data lake. And now, like we said, we want to be able to make decisions and report off of it and make sense of this data. All that data in the data lake is completely unstructured. It's in all different forms. It's not relatable in any sense, so we can't really report off it. That's where the data warehouse comes in. The goal of a data warehouse is to take all of that data and turn it into a single source of clean, formatted, organized data, some sort of structure of it's probably a separate database with separate schemas and tables, all this stuff that is separate and structured in that way for you to use. And there's a lot of strategies that you'll find for using this. You know, common ones are dimensional modeling, Kimball, star schema, you know, normalize, denormalize, all this stuff. And you can get on and on about which approach is best. But ultimately, the goal here is to create a single source, organized form of your raw data. And you're typically going to update this on a cadence. So maybe once an hour, once a day, whatever, you're pulling from this data lake, updating your data warehouse cleaned up models by running transformations, adding business logic, all this stuff, so that you have something clean and easy to work with. Not only is it more organized, easier to interpret, kind of a consistent look, but performance might be better as well, because you're going to have keys and relationships and things that make more sense. This is also where you'll see the concepts of facts and dimensions, possibly, or the idea of slowly changing dimensions. Again, these are things outside the scope of this video, but at a high level, that is the purpose of a data warehouse. You are taking this unstructured, all over the place data and creating a single source of organized truth for companies to make decisions and use their data however they want. So hopefully now you have a better understanding of the difference between these two important topics of a data lake and a data warehouse. And these are two really critical components of a modern data stack. And one thing that might be helpful for you to kind of visualize this more is to see the whole modern stack maybe in one place. And if that's something you're interested in, I do have a free guide that you can download and just use for yourself. It's called the Starter Guide for the Modern Data Stack. I'll add a link below. So again, I hope you found this helpful. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you next week.